And from the time I went back, the boy was 3 years, 4 years old, and I brought the boy to the orphanage center. And now that boy, he has graduated the secondary school. And now that boy is a teacher, teaching in a school, in primary school, taking care of other orphans.
Mm.
And he always sit down and say, if I did not get opportunity, where would I have been?
Mm.
You know, so when I look back into kind of his stories, the boy was dumb in the bush. And then the auntie came looking for the boy, the baby, where she didn't even know where she dumped the boy. And then the boy cried, and she came back and picked the boy, and she took care of the boy until the time I find the boy again, with her, struggling with her, when the boy was 3 years old or 4 years old, and I brought him to the orphanage center. And now we educated that boy from nursery, from primary school to the secondary school, and William Deng right now is ready to go to university.
Mm.
It is amazing. And that one, I could see that's the difference between that organization, Live Up the Vulnerable, that is life-saving and is a transformation. And is the living history that will never be forgotten in the people of South Sudan life. So we really appreciate, we really so very thankful for the all people who stood with us all this time.
Mm.
And to this very day, we still need that kind of care, because that's what we can do for humanity.
Yeah. When you combat human trafficking and invest in long-term care in war zones where there is such extreme poverty, you have to do it for the long run. And it's through the generations. So you investing in Dengir investing in the students he's working with now, and generation after generation, transformation will grow. Transformation is already here, but transformation will grow and expand. And even I'm so excited because you already have two students that have finished university, and one is working as a medical cleric, and one is working giving back for a food program organization. And so they're continuing the legacy of your vision those many years ago to return to your village and stand with the most vulnerable. And it's an exciting, important, essential gift that we can participate in, and we need your help. And we invite you to visit liftupthevulnerable.org, donate today, learn more, share the story. The story needs to be told.
Yeah.
The people of South Sudan and Sudan need their voices to be lifted. They have a powerful vision and a powerful gift to this world if we're willing to listen. Thank you for joining us.